right, what's going on, you guys? Nick here with Nick Strength and Power. I've got a couple of interesting stories for you guys today. Hope you guys are having a great Super Bowl weekend so far. I might not post a video tomorrow because the Super Bowl, so I want to squeeze this one out today. So the first story that I have for you guys today is a Sean Roden story. So Sean Roden, a couple nights ago, did a Q&A on his Instagram story where he answered a lot of questions that we've all really been wanting to know the answer to. Now, a couple of those answers were pretty interesting. The first question, are you ready for the Mr. Olympia 2020? Sean Roden responds with 100% yes. But then he also has a picture of him when he first began bodybuilding. So easily, this could have just been a joke and posting the old picture as if it were an update picture for the 2020 Olympia. So that first question could be interpreted any number of ways. He's probably not being serious about competing at the 2020 Olympia, but he could be. I mean, it's a possibility. But you guys already know how I feel. I think we're going to see him at Athleticon. Now, that brings me to the other question, which was a little bit more black and white and a little bit more of a direct answer. So this question is a question that has been kind of speculated on and controversial over the past couple of months. There's been different websites that have published different sources that they've had stating that Sean Roden is not an IFBB pro. Some websites were saying that Sean simply did not pay his membership fees for 2020. Some websites were saying that his membership was actually revoked. Now, the IFBB pro status is a yearly membership, so it is something that needs to be renewed from year to year. As you guys know, it is 2020. The situation with Sean Roden and all the backlash that came along with it happened in 2019. That was last year. Obviously, Sean Roden was an IFBB pro in 2019, but it's a new year, and the situation with Sean had not been resolved. So all these reports that were coming out about Sean not being an IFBB pro seemed kind of likely. I mean, he was banned from the Olympia. He wasn't competing in any shows. He was supposed to do the Arnold Classic in March, but he did not do it because I guess they wouldn't have him. But Sean's answer to this question on his Q&A was yes, he is still an IFBB pro. Now, to be honest with you guys, the people that I had heard from that Sean was not an IFBB pro, to me, were pretty credible sources, but I don't think it gets any more credible than straight from the horse's mouth himself that he is still an IFBB pro. So I think that if that's true, I mean, I guess that's a positive, you know, swing in the Sean Roden story. You know, I was kind of surprised when I heard different websites throwing out this terminology of that his pro card was revoked, and specifically using the word revoked, because that would mean a little bit more than just not renewing your pro card. That would mean they took his pro card away from him, which to me would be a step that goes a lot further than him not renewing it. But look, man, as far as Sean's pro status is concerned, as far as the 2020 Olympia is concerned, I hope he's telling the truth about both. I hope he is an IFBB pro still. I hope he is wanting to compete at the 2020 Mr. Olympia, and I hope he's able to. I'm hoping that like all this stuff is resolved. He's found to be innocent, if he is innocent, and Sean can reinstate himself as Mr. Olympia. I mean, he is a pro bodybuilder. That's his life. That's his career. That's his passion. He won the biggest title you can win in pro bodybuilding. So if he is innocent, I really want to see him be able to come back and do what he loves, do what he's paid to do, and do what he was the best in the world at in 2018. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below about the whole Sean Roden situation. Now, next up in the news, Arnold Classic 2020 news. Here we go yet again. Now, William Bonac, who I've said before, I believe is Big Rami's biggest competition at this 2020 Arnold Classic. William Bonac, I think, has a lot of attributes to his physique that could beat Rami if Rami comes in off, meaning Rami doesn't have conditioning. Now, we saw that picture of Big Rami. This picture, I'll show it to you guys again. Big Rami's showing off his hamstrings, his legs from the side, and the fact that he already has striations in his glutes at a little over 4 weeks out from the Arnold. In other words, Rami is trying to show us that he is in shape. Now, William Bonac was not going to take that lying down because William Bonac posted his own physique update, specifically a conditioning update at about 4 weeks out. Well, he has it at 5 weeks out from the Arnold Classic. And his caption there is, "Sorry to interrupt you with your evening, but am I too early for this year's Christmas Eve?" Now, obviously, the implication of that caption is the fact that he already has a Christmas tree in his lower back, which is a hallmark sign of good conditioning. And the Christmas tree is something you're looking for when the bodybuilder is actually on stage the day of the show, if their conditioning is good. Now, Bonac is saying this is 5 weeks out. It is pretty much closer to 4 weeks out if this picture was taken like right now. But I think what we're seeing is a very good sign. Big Rami is someone we need to see conditioned. William Bonac is somebody that we need to see conditioned. And like I said in my prediction video, I think the Arnold Classic is going to be the battle of conditioning. We know that Big Rami has the size to beat almost everybody on that stage. He's bigger than almost everybody on that stage. William Bonac, he has the muscle mass pound for pound to beat everybody on that stage. But it's really a question of who's going to be sharper and who's going to be in better shape, because they are both incredible bodybuilders from the standpoint of how much muscle they have packed on their bodies. But the question is, who will have the best conditioned muscle the day of the show, the first weekend of March? Now, next up in the news, on the Muscular Development YouTube channel, they had an interview with Phil Heath where he speaks a little bit on the Breaking Olympia film. Now, a couple of the things that he said about this film I thought were interesting. Number one, he said one of the reasons why he wanted to make his own documentary was essentially that he didn't like the way Generation Iron portrayed him in that movie to be the villain, because that really set the tone for how people viewed Phil Heath after that movie came out. And then, of course, us, the other bodybuilding news outlets, in our clickbait narratives, trying to shape the public opinion of Phil Heath, apparently. But in any case, Phil talks about how the main inspiration for this documentary is the fact that he wants to shape his own narrative. And he also says they're in the very early stages of actually filming and making the documentary, which to me is kind of a telltale sign. Maybe this documentary will not be released before Athleticon, because one interesting thing that Phil said towards the end of the video, towards the end of the interview, rather, is that the story told in this documentary could change in the coming months. Now, within the coming months, we have both the Olympia and Athleticon, so maybe the movie will be released after, and it will be about the comeback of Phil Heath, and not just a documentary about Phil Heath's journey so far. But in any case, Philip, I wish you the best. I'm sure I'm going to watch the documentary, and I'm sure wherever you decide you make your comeback, I will be covering that show as well. Now, let's go ahead and dive into the final story that I have for you guys today. So, Joseph Rogan, the host of the Joe Rogan Experience, a couple months ago, he had a little bit of an incident where he did the weigh-ins for Sober October 3. And he took his shirt off when he was weighing in, and a lot of people noticed that Joe Rogan's midsection was a little bit distended. Some might say a bubble gut. I even did a video on it where I talked about how I feel it was more just the way that his physique is built and just the layout of him being a shorter guy, the way that his arms seem to be pretty long compared to his torso, and just the way overall his weight is distributed. His midsection and his core appear very thick. And I, you know, even though he has admitted to, you know, some hormone replacement therapy including but not limited to GH, which has been cited as a possible cause of the actual bubble gut that we see in bodybuilding, I really didn't think that was what was causing it. Now, Joe Rogan actually posted a video on his Instagram page that received, at this point, over 3 million views talking about this carnivore diet that he's done over the past month of January. And then he even talks about the fact that he had a gut in that original, that weigh-in video. So then Mr. Rogan takes off his shirt. He says he's lost his gut, he's lost his love handles, and he's lost also 12 pounds over the month of January just doing this carnivore diet. He goes on to talk about his energy levels and general aches and pains that he seemed to have improved with this carnivore diet. So the question that I have for you guys is, what do you think about Joe Rogan's physique? What do you think about his carnivore diet as well? But what do you think about the whole Rogan bubble gate, we'll call it, the bubble gut scandal of 2020? Do you think he still has it? Do you think he got rid of it? Do you think it's simply the way he's built, the shortness of his torso? Or are you extremely skeptic and you think it's a result of the HGH? But in any case, I love Joe Rogan. The dude's an icon, and I think he looks phenomenal. So that wraps it up for the video today, guys. Please give it a thumbs up if you did, in fact, enjoy it. And as always, Nick Strength and Power, signing out.